Welcome back. In this section on calculating gamma by hand, we are going to talk about finding discordant pairs. So in the last segment of our video, we talked about finding concordant pairs. So we talked about pairs where they're higher on both variables. Now we're going to look at pairs that are higher on one variable but lower on the other. So with concordant pairs, we started over here in cell A. Let's go ahead and label all of our cells real quick. So we are going to once again label them as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, and T. So when we talked about concordant pairs, we started over here with cell A, and the concordant pairs were the ones that are catty-corner this direction. This time, we're going to start over here with cell E, and the cells that are discordant with cell E are the cells that are lower on one variable but higher on the other variable. So cell E is as high as you can be on degree, but as low as you can be in social class. And so the cells that are higher on social class but lower in education would be the ones that are catty-corner this direction. And so the discordant pairs to cell E are going to be these ones. These are the discordant pairs. F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take the value in cell E, which is 0, and we're going to multiply that by the sum of the values in F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S. So we're going to do that for E. Then we're going to take the values in, we're going to move to the left. So we're going to go to cell D. And the cells that are discordant to cell D are going to be these ones circled in yellow. They are going to be F, G, H, K, L, M, P, Q, R. So we're going to take the value in cell D, which is 3, and we're going to multiply it by the values in these cells. Then we're going to move on to to cell C, and cell C is discordant with these cells. F, G, K, L, P, Q. So again, we're going to take the value in cell 4 and multiply it by the values in those cells. Then we have cell B. And cell B's discordant cells are going to be here along the left side, F, K, P. Now, cell A does not have any discordant cells because cell A is as low as it can be on all of the values. So then we would move to cell J. And the discordant cells to cell J are going to be K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S. So again, we would take the value of the cell J and multiply that by the values in K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S. Then we move on to cell I, and for cell I, the discordant cells are K, L, M, P, Q, R. And so we move right down, and then we move on to cell H, and cell H is K, L, P, Q, and then we move on to cell G. And cell G is K and P. And then cell F does not have any discordant pairs. There's nothing that can be lower than F on highest degree. And so there are no discordant pairs with cell F. So then we move down to cell O. And for cell O, we have the discordant pairs of PQRS. So again, we're going to take the value in cell O, which is 90, and multiply that by 3 plus 19 plus 4 plus 13. Then we move to cell then we move to cell N, and the discordant pairs with cell N are PQR. And then cell M is going to be cells PQ are going to be discordant with cell M. So we'll take the value in cell M, multiply it by P plus Q. And then our last discordant cell is going to be cell L. And the cell that is discordant to cell L is cell P. So let's go ahead and do that math and calculate our discordant pairs. All right, so we are going to have, we're going to start with cell E. And cell E is going to be 0 because we're multiplying 0 by a bunch of stuff. So it's just always, it's going to come out as 0. So then we move to cell D, and cell D is 3 times 48 plus 424 plus 110 plus 52 plus 286 plus 75 plus 4 plus 19 plus 3. And so that's going to give you 3 times 1021, which is 3063. So then we move on to cell C. And for cell C, we're going to have 4 times 424 plus 110 plus 52 plus 286 plus 75 plus... Oh, wait. Hold on. I made a mistake. Let's go back. We are going to do 424 plus 110 plus 286 plus 75 plus 19 plus 3. Sorry, added a wrong one in there. So we're going to have 4 times 9, 17, which is going to be 3668. And then we're going to move to cell B, which is going to be 57 times 110 plus 75 plus 3, which is going to give us 57 times 188, which equals 10,716. Okay? So then we're going to keep going, and we're going to go on to cell J. So for cell J, oops, wrong color. For cell J, we're going to have 24 times 166 plus 52 plus 280, oops, that's a 52, plus 286 plus 75. Plus 13 plus 4 plus 19 plus 3. So we're going to have 24 times 618, which is going to give us 14,832. So that's the discordant pairs for cell J. Then cell I is going to be 66 times 52 plus 286 plus 75 plus 4 plus 19 plus 3. It's going to give us 66 times 439, which equals 28,974. So that's cell I. Then we move on to cell H. And cell H is going to be 48 times 286 plus 75 plus 4 plus, scratch that. 286 plus 75 plus 19 plus 3. And that's going to give us 48 times 383, which equals 18,384. And then we're going to have cell G, which is going to be 424 times 75 plus 3, which is 484 times 78, which equals 33072. So then we have four more to do. So then for cell O, you have 90 times 13 plus 4 plus 19 plus 3. It's going to equal 90 times 39, which is 3510. And then we're going to have cell N. We'll have cell N, which is going to be 166 times 4 plus 19 plus 3, which is going to be 166 times 26, which is 4316. Then we have cell M, which is 52 times 19 plus 3, 52 times 22, 1144. And then our very last cell that has discordant pairs is cell L. And cell L is 286 times 3. And that's going to give us 858. So now what we want to do is we want to get the D in our equation for gamma. So D is the discordant pairs total. And so we're going to take all of these totals that we have so far that we have added together, the things that we've circled in yellow in the last couple of slides, we're going to add those up. And it's going to give us a total of 122,537. And so this is our D in our equation for gamma. So now we're going to put in the C and the D, and we're going to be able to actually calculate gamma. All right, so our equation for gamma is C minus D divided by C plus D. So we calculated C in the last segment, and now we've just calculated D. So we're going to plug those numbers into our equation. And I'm going to go ahead and write those down at the bottom. So if C is 300,259 minus D, which we just calculated is 122,000,
537. And we're dividing that by 316, 259, plus 122, 537. And that's going to give us 193,722 divided by 438,796. And that gives us a gamma of 0.44. And that is our answer for gamma. So what does that mean? How would we interpret that? What does this number tell us about gamma? So remember that gamma is a number that ranges from negative 1 to plus 1, with 0 indicating no relationship, and plus 1 and minus 1 indicating kind of a perfect or the strongest possible relationship. So on the number line, the gamma that we've calculated is here, about 0.44. So this gamma is a moderate relationship. It's not weak. It's not super strong, but there seems to be a pretty moderate relationship or association between these two variables. Also, that relationship is positive, which means that as the values increase in respondents' degree, the values also increase in respondents' social class, which supports the hypothesis that we stated at the beginning that if you have a higher degree, then you are likely to have a higher social class. So that's how we would interpret that. We would want our interpretation to include the number for gamma, whether it's positive or negative, whether it's strong or weak, and then relate it back to the hypothesis. And so that's how you would interpret the gamma. All right, and that concludes our calculations of measures of association.